Hey everyone, welcome back to Tech DIY's Playground session. This time, we are playing around with some widely used plugins and their configurations. These plugins will improve your productivity and make your coding experience more exciting. So the plugins we are talking about today are Material Themes, Rainbow Brackets, JSON Utils, and JSON Parsers. JSON Utils, JSON Parsers are It's just like finding a needle in a haystack. And JSON parser is like validating your JSONs and beautify them right into your IDE. We don't need to go anywhere else. Before moving ahead, hit the like button, share and subscribe. Press the bell icon for prompt notifications. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first plugin we are talking about is Matte Themes. So press twice shift and type plugins. So it will open this plugin pop-up. And this in this plugin pop-up, you can see the installed plugins, what we are having in our IDE. So I'm choosing the Matte Themes. Matte Themes are basically Google Material Themes, which are very famous. I mean, most of the coding community know about that. If for those who don't know, Matte Themes are basically Android themes, whatever are provided by Google, and they are very colorful, very dynamic. So we can make our IntelliJ also like that, and it includes the Atom themes also, because Atom editor is also one of the most famous Mac editors. So So we can make use of those cool themes and make our coding experience more better. In terms of we can work on extending hours also. If we are sometimes we feel like okay, bored doing the same, looking at the same IDE, same fonts. So that times for those times we can just go ahead and change the dark themes also. And in the dark themes also, it has various variants like Oceanic Blue, Oceanic Dark, so, and Atom themes and GitLab dark themes. All those themes we can just select here, and we can switch to them and make our IDE experience more better, more exciting. Okay, so we can do like that. So I just have one theme currently, that is Oceanic, and I'm just going to before recording this session, I have already installed the Matte theme, so I will just show where we can get that and all. I have installed that. When we will start the IDE, just after installing that, it will show us a widget will come, and it will show us the steps for setting up the IDE. But don't worry guys, that is very very straightforward and intuitive, so you can refer that one. So I'm just opening my IDE, and I will show you the configurations or how the Matte themes will look, the various variants it is having. So yeah, as you can see, the Matte theme Oceanic is loading on my Oceanic Dark, so it is opening in my IDE, loading my IDE, and yeah, hit the bell icon for prompt notification, subscribe and hit the bell icon for prompt notification. As you can see, the IDE is loaded now. So IDE is loaded now, and as you can see in the right bottom, it shows the currently available theme, and this balloon pop-up came, and here we can support them. Click on this gear button and it will open the settings for this notification settings. So here we can configure the themes notification, like how the themes notification should look, and all kind of customization we can do here, whatever customization we need with the themes, so that we can do here. Yeah, and the next thing in this session, we are talking about the Rainbow Brackets. So Rainbow Brackets is a kind of plugin which allows us to, you know, segregate or separate the brackets, inner brackets, how the brackets are looking, or if we are having nested inner blocks, so those blocks can be easily identified by the colorful brackets. It has the color coding for each bracket we are having, opening and closing brackets. So just like as you can see here, these are the different brackets, and each bracket will be having opening and closing of each bracket would be having same color, as you can see in line number 16, and closing bracket of that same is in line number 18, and line number 14 where the class is starting, so it is having different color. So by this color coding we can easily identify. And again, press double shift and type theme, so it will open the themes pop-up as you can see in the screen. So now we can select the theme, and it will dynamically change behind the preview will be shown as we can choose the different themes. So that's cool, right? I mean, we can see then and there itself, and we can, you know, by doing this in this theme pop-up, as you can see, I'm changing the themes, and behind the pop-up, the whole scene is changing as per the selected theme. So isn't it cool, right? So whichever theme we want, we can just select. So yeah, as you can see, just have a look on different themes. So these are around some 15 or 20 themes with the existing Darkula also. So this was the Darkula theme which comes with IDE, I mean IntelliJ itself, and we can have different themes as we have in the Visual Code, VS Code, or any other, you know, coding editor. So same way. So this was the experience of themes. Now the next plugin we are talking about are related to JSON. Okay, so JSON parser, JSON utils, these are the plugins we will be talking about. But before going there, just we can have a, you know, information about the MAT themes, like who have created them, people who have created them, and Codata is also very good in this space, plugins space, I can say. And this was the Rainbow plugin I was talking about. So Rainbow Bracket, it is very small plugin, but it is really very helpful when we can differentiate the blocks, code blocks. Because when the number of lines of the codes increases and the view goes beyond the screen limits, it will be very difficult to identify. Okay, yeah. So these, if we are not using any JSON plugin, you guys most of you would be knowing about these JSON query tool. So JSON query tool is basically a place where we can, you know, put our copy our response JSON, and we can write a JSON query. So in the output panel, it will show the that particular JSON value. Okay, so as you can see here, I have just pasted my input JSON and typed the query, and giving the key itself would show me in the output, it would show the exact value for that key. Or if we can give the array, so it will give the full thing. And the next is JSON parser. JSON parsers are basically, these are the small plugins, which plugins or programs, which what they do is, if we are having a cumbersome JSON, we can just copy them and paste them here in the JSON parsers. So they will check for the validity if there is any error in the JSON file, and if they can also beautify the JSONs. So as I pasted my JSON here, and yeah, it has beautified the JSON in the proper with the proper indentation and proper spacing. So this is how the JSON parser works. Online JSON parser work. As you can see, this it has shown me the error and everything. So now think of if we are having some data which we don't want to share online, then these tools, we should not use these tools. So what we can do in that case? So in that case, in our IntelliJ itself, we can add these plugins, JSON tools and JSON parser. So this is the JSON tools. And to switch to any view or to navigate to any tab or any view, we can simply press Command E in Mac and Control E in Windows, and then through tab or shift tab we can move around in the views pop-up. Okay, so similar way, I'm just writing a simple JSON to show you the use of JSON utils. This is the JSON utils plugin, by the way, and here in JSON utils input we are giving the input in the form of simple JSON. But believe me guys, in real life the JSON would be huge. This kind of array JSON would be having, you can say, like hundreds of lines of code, JSON keys and values and like that hundreds of pairs would be there in response JSON. So in those cases, in those cumbersome JSONs, finding a particular value would be an effort of just like finding a needle in a haystack. So this is a haystack, and we need to find a needle. Needle means a key and its value. So that we can do through this util, and it's very very helpful and quick. So what we need to do, yes, before moving ahead, don't forget our target is target 100k subs, and share, subscribe for prompt notification and press the bell icon for prompt notification. Yes, so this is the JSON. In JSON path we need to write this kind of query where we are saying like dollar, then star, then key name, what key we want to show, see in the haystack. So we are giving the message array, and then we are saying dot star, that cover star means, as we all know, everything. Then we are saying target. So once we hit the target, it was showing target 100k. So guys, please help us in reaching there. Sooner or later we will definitely reach there, but yeah, I am very very thankful for the help and support you guys are providing me. And yes, when I press here dot subs, when I given here dot subs, so it has given me that particular value from the array, right? So it has given me, it's telling us to like, share, subscribe. Similar way, so this is what it is, and next is JSON parser. So I will just copy the input JSON in one line JSON that is not looking good at all. So we just copy it and we will paste it in the JSON parser. So I will show you that as well. So we are copying it. Yeah. And now we are going to open JSON parser. This is what I was telling about. This is the view pop-up. And with tab we have moved and we have opened the JSON parser. Now just for the better visibility, I have maximized this view, and now I have pasted the query, the JSON here, and just click on parse and it has shown me the full JSON with proper spacing and indentation, beautified JSON I can say. So yeah, so this JSON we can make use of in our code. In API development, we can have a request in JSON format or response in JSON format. But many a times when we hit through browser, so we get them in the single line. So this tool we can make use of to get that beautified, and we can, you know, these two tools specifically, JSON Utils and JSON Parser, I found it very, very good, and they will help improve your productivity instead of, you know, copy pasting them in some Notepad++ or any different kind of, you know, editors. It's better to have it here in the IntelliJ IDEA itself and work around. So yes, with this, here ends our session. Thanks for watching, guys. And yes, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and hit the bell icon for prompt notification. And until next exciting session, have a good life, enjoy, stay safe, and keep learning. Keep learning, keep doing good things, and yeah, enjoy life. Bye.